So I remember having a couple of discussions with Ivan about this. They weren't necessarily my own interest. I was telling him that they weren't priced properly. That was adjusted to him too in time.
I didn't want too many people to start with, quite rightly. We were far too green. But they took off when the Eboni people, the inspector, travel farmed. And we got a letter in the Irish Times saying that it was very good and could become famous. And that little article had such an effect on our numbers. I think straight away, I remember thinking it, the number of people for dinner went up by, multiplied by 2 or 3 times.
At one stage, quite early on, Myrtle had and Ballymaloe had the top rating in the food guides in the British Isles. And so the chefs, and so on, were saying, "Who the hell is this woman, who's opened a restaurant down in a farm, in the middle of a farm in a country house down in the country, and she writes the menu every day, and it all seems so amateurish to them." They were astonished that somebody who'd broken all the rules, that this was the place that was seemed to be being acknowledged by the guides.
Ballymaloe House and the Yates Room restaurant is one of three which this year won the accolade of a Laurel Cluster in the Good Food Guide. In all of England, only a dozen are equally honoured. In Scotland, one. In Wales, none at all.
They were instrumental in the formation of the Blue Book, which is an association with over 40 members today of some of the finest properties in Ireland. When they started back in, I think it was the early 70s, they put that association together. There was only 5 members in it, and Myrtle and the Allens were hugely influential in pulling it together. Many other countries sell destinations. Ireland sell a touring holiday predominantly, and that is very much down to the fact that back in the 60s and back in the 70s, they worked together to promote coming into Dublin, going over to Galway and coming down the West Coast, and that is part of the whole bedrock of tourism in Ireland.
We always loved having people. We had lots of friends that came to see us long before we ever had a restaurant. And I think we greet them as friends and they feel comfortable and welcome. And that's the best you can do, really, if you're running a hotel.
First of all, she's an innkeeper. She's a keeper of an old country house, and hospitality comes with that. And her approach is to feeding her friends, is to feeding her guests. And I think that has worked really, really well. I've found an awful lot of followers worldwide.
I think they feel that we're informal. When we first took the first few guests, my husband and I said, "Well, we've got to have them. And if they ask us to stand on our heads, we'll stand on our head for them. We'll do whatever to please them and get them coming back."
In the later days, Ivan would sit in the hall lapping up the sort of compliments, I suppose, and he used to say, occasionally being mistaken for the porter by first-time guests, and of course he would immediately take the case.